This world is not my home, I'm just a passing through. My treasures are laid up somewhere beyond the blue. The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no...
14 talks about you don't know what tomorrow holds. How can you brag about what you will do tomorrow? What is your life? ? Your life is nothing but a mist, a vapor that appears today and is gone tomorrow. That viable verse describe the fact of life, the reality of life, that you and I are a creature that is suffering from a terminal sickness, which is called life itself. It will end in death. And that expiration date, you and I does not know. Some people have the privilege of seeing it approaching. One of that lucky, depending on how you see it, person, is a friend of mine whose picture will appear somewhere in this video. A very dear friend of mine. I call him High Chief Oloja. I think he got a new chieftaincy title last year. He's Obagbemisuga. It's like the king exalted me, or whatever the name is. So that is a real high chief. And he just passed last night. Transition to eternity last night. And it brought back the message I've been preaching for the last, since I started this video. I've been stressing it, that life is terminal. Why is that important? Just as the book of James said in chapter 4, verse 14, you don't know what tomorrow holds. So the best decision you can do for yourself and your family is to enjoy every day as if it's your last, because you never know. You just don't know. I don't care how healthy you are. No matter how healthy you are, no matter how strong you are, it doesn't matter. Life can just take you out like that. I know we Christians always say, I reject that in Jesus' name. No bad vision will happen. But hey, have you ever seen anybody who live forever? You can do yourself a big favor by watching a video of Steve Jobs, a graduation address he gave at Harvard. And he said, there's no need to be afraid, because life is the best gift that every one of us have. It keeps us motivated and stops us from wasting time, because you know you are a dead man walking anyway. He put it this way. He said, you're already naked, so there's no need to be ashamed. Do what you have to do. Live your own life. Do not dance to the tune of other people, which you call, that's a dogma, where you dance to the music being played by other people. Play your own music. So death itself is an encouragement for us to live our authentic life now, because we never know what will happen. As I'm reflecting on the passing of my dear friend, as I said, this picture will appear, some of you might know him. Oh, really good friend. I will never forget him. Every time he called me, he's like, my pastor, he has a way of saying it that just bring a smile to my face. Anytime he called me, my pastor, was with him, took him for his medical appointment less than 4 weeks ago, was with him, talked, did a lot of things together that day, and unfortunately, he's gone now. On from this side of the world, we'll meet again. I'm sure of that, we'll meet again. Because as a pastor, whenever I talk to him, I talk to him about his salvation. So I know we'll meet again. But my point, the reason why I'm making this video is, how are you living your life? Some of us live our life as if we'll never leave this place. Let me tell you something. In the last 2 years, and I'm serious, in the last 2 years, I'm not sure, I don't think it's 2 years or just over 2 years now, we've had in the Nigerian community in St. Louis, we have lost 4 young people. No, let me say 3. Because I remember I was with him about 2 years ago. We were talking. One of our friends, Muyiwa, just passed in March of that year, I think. And then unfortunately, another brother was in Nigeria visiting and was murdered by armed robbers. He was just 56. So we are doing a song of praise for him in July of 2 years ago. And we're just talking about it. The same brother I'm talking about now is the one that just left us. How do you know when it's going to be your time? Are you prepared for your exit? Do you have a place you know you will meet again? Please take good care of your salvation. This is the only time you can do that now. God bless you.